Ramadan 2022, we eat in steak.
Two Pakistani aunties. We like what you've done with the place. Please
have you
tell
been
us.
Recording the whole time?
No, I just started. The cold has aged them 10 years.
Safiya always looks the
Puddles!
I want to feel the water on my feet.
What if this water has tetanus in it?
Huh? What if it has what?
Tetanus.
Tetanus. I got my shots.
You didn't get your shots? I did get my shots too.
I'm vaccinated, baby!
Is that a square or a circle?
It's
a house!
It's a shape that I invented.
It's a house with a little window.
Is currently seeking knowledge through the Masters of Divinity program at the University of Chicago, hoping to catch some wisdoms along the way, which I think is a beautiful way of putting being in graduate school. So now please join me in welcoming Safiya.
I also show, I hope I show, that religious discourse around Muslims use the same racist devices as fetish discourse does around Africans. Perhaps a recycling of an existing political framework for new political interests. Pretty much my argument is that the fetish is a technology of racism. It is what allows the study of religion to be racist. It's what allows the study of religion to participate in white supremacy.
Today was tax day. Masha'Allah, tabarakallah, these kids did their taxes for the first time. This adult lady right here.
Got our deductibles unlocked.
Yep. Masha'Allah. I actually didn't file my taxes. I filed for an extension to do my taxes later. That's what you call procrastination. One day I'll be an adult, but I'm gonna procrastinate as long as I can. Right, so it's mid-Ramadan, and we're going for iftar. We're going for some free food and some community, inshallah. Look at them, huddled up, bundled up, fat jackets. Why? Because apparently it's supposed to be spring, April, but Chicago is a liar. And it's always winter here. It's always winter. Winter is coming is not the phrase here. Winter will never leave is the phrase here. Safiya and Hajj adventures to the lake. Finally, spring has come to Chicago.
Finally.
April is almost over and now it comes.
Right. Next up, the water.
Okay, go.
Yo, you need water?
Please send this in Pasuri. I mean, look how much I love your panjiri.
She fit into her hijab and her clothes.
Oh my god, my lift is here.
I guess we'll clean up your mess after.
Hadra, routine making master.
Figure out how to like email. Add you to.
Okay, so the craziest thing happens. Subhanallah. Some Ramadan magic maybe, or just you gotta take chances in life, and sometimes you gonna get rainbows. So So I go to this event, and Malcolm X's daughter, one of his daughters, Eliasa Shabazz, is talking. She's speaking. I'm like, should I ask a question? Should I talk to her? And I was like, what am I even gonna ask her? And then I asked myself, what do you want from her? And I'm like, you know what I want? I wanna take her on a date. That's what I wanna do. I wanna take her on a date and I wanna talk to her. I wanna get to know her. So I wait in line. Everybody wants to talk to her. It's like 15 minutes until iftar. And I talk to her and I ask her, you got an iftar date? Can I take you out for iftar? And she says, no, I already got plans. And then she's like, then I'm like, can I take you out later though? And then she's like, but I'm not from Chicago. I'm from New York. And I'm like, well, that's great, cause I'm from Brooklyn. And then she's like, what do you do here? And I tell her, well, I'm at the Divinity School. And actually one of the things that I wanna advocate for is that Malcolm, through his political theology, was actually a feminist. Put that in scare quotes. But essentially, he advocated for the welfare, the well-being, and the full dignity and humanity of women. He advocated for community love for women, for community appreciation of women. And the fact that his daughters and his wife are who they are, and to this day love him so much, is a testament to that. Anyway, and a lot of people criticize Malcolm for being anti-woman, as being too traditionalist. And they look for ideological mimicry of the dogma that they have in feminist discourse today, that they miss the point. They miss his, his political vision. They miss his communal and family practice. So anyway, so I tell her that, and she is like nodding her head, yes, thank you. And she said, what you doing May 19th or 18th? I gotta figure out the dates. But she's like, what you doing then? And she said, they're having a panel event for Malcolm for his birthday. And she said, I think you should speak. And I'm like, okay. I tell her verbatim, I tell her, you know, I would be honored and I would want to speak from my mind, but I'm afraid that I'm gonna speak from my butt. She's like, no, you'll be fine. She's very generous, very nice, mashallah. So she's like, can you fly out then? Can you be there in New York then? And I'm like, for you, I will go anywhere. I will be in New York reporting for duty. So subhanAllah, she's like, I just email me and we're gonna make this happen. So subhanAllah. Shoot your shot. You don't have to be romantic. You don't have to be husband hunting, but shoot your shot. And like, who are the people you want to talk to? Who are the people you want to be with? Who are the people you want to learn from? Like, one thing that I'm really trying to do these days is figuring out who my teachers are. Who are the people I want to learn from, and selecting my teachers, not just being given them, right? Because that's how education normally is, right? You just show up in a classroom and your teacher is who you get. It doesn't matter who the person is. No, it matters. It's everything. Yeah, so I've been searching for teachers, hunting for teachers, and something in my gut said, you gotta ask her out. You know, like, not just as a teacher, but like as a sister. Like, she is someone I want to be a sister with, you know, that somebody I want to be in community with, someone that I want to learn from as a kind of like communal ancestor. Anyway, because Malcolm, for sure,
was a communal ancestor. Anyway, so mashallah, breaking my fast with this lacrosse, cause we fancy out here in the grad school life. No, we not. We playing ourselves. Anyway, peace out. Ramadan Mubarak.
Behind the scenes. Yeah, and camera ready. For Downton Abbey.
DC style!
It's not on me.
What's your name? Choose a name for yourself.
I thought you were literally asking. Downton, I was so offended. Abbey. I was like, okay, I don't know. Downton Abbey? Don't make like Gertrude? Good. Agnes? I haven't watched Downton Abbey.
No. You have, like, just make it up. Like a Dacified Downton Abbey.
Okay, don't put the camera on.
No. You know how the new season of Bridgerton has like the Indian girl? Yeah, I haven't seen it either. But her name is like something Sharma.
Ew, Sharma.
Yeah.
No, that's like
she's Indian. Oh my god, don't.
Okay, I'll be my Bengali name is Prava. Mm-hmm. I will Prava? Be Prava.
Prava.
You can be Nirvana.
Oh my god.
Nirvana?
Okay.
Well, all right, sounds like, you know what? You name me as well then.
I'm Deji.
I feel like you can be in Asma. But like not Asma, Asma.
Okay.
And you can be a Ikra.
And of Faraho would be
Fareha.
There you go.
Fareha.
That's too much flourish.
Too much flourish itself is already flourishy enough.
Alright. What was your name again? Asma. Thank you for having us in your beautiful home. Yes, do tell us. Where did you get all of this spread?
You have to do a voiceover. I can't.
This is your idea, dude.
See what?
All right, first.
First, we got the souffle. Show the souffle, not me.
Where's your snobby? I'm better than thou accent.
First, we have the souffle.
That's too not. Oh yeah, yeah. I like the shrill at the end. Yeah, that was good.
It's super Nigel Thornberry. Yeah. All right.
Nigel Thornberry. Yes.
Like the cartoon.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, his mom was British, and she owned an estate, and, like, that.
Oh, really? I never watched it. Mm-hmm. I only know about the feral child.
Donnie.
Who are these people?
You know that cartoon, The Wild Thornberries?
No. This is so white.
Oh, my God.
Sounds so white.
What was that? Like, Cartoon Network?
Nickelodeon.
I didn't have cable.
Her eyes are there coming. Like, she's about to say something.
What?
Yeah.
She's say something what?
You're not on cable.
You know, I thought she was going to say, some working class. No. Say some poor.
No.
Say some city. But the poor type, the slums, the ghettos.
She's got nothing to say because she's thinking, yes, I am.
She in the back of my mind. Terrified. Are you guys holding her hostage or something?
It was merely a commentary on my cushy suburban upbringing, nothing else.
She said I grew up on the streets of Brooklyn.
You did.
Oh my god.
Never let anyone forget it.
Did you put chini?
Nope.
You want chini?
What is this?
She's too poor, Virginia.
What? What?
That is a commodity.
Yeah, thanks to the British and slavery.
Can you give me an...
Bro, this is so out of pocket right now.
No.
Don't cry over spilled chai.
missed most of it. But I'll trust your comment.
It was a lot of fun. I mean, okay, let's do it. The
Saracens.
Oh yes, very.
The Saracens provided
the Saracen flesh.
Ew.
Yeah, the UCE. Okay.
Yes.
she didn't know about the cannibalism? Okay.
I don't think anyone knows about
please
this.
Don't. No.
Yeah. Okay.
This is chocolate from?
No. The Saracens.
From okay. Saracens.
That's it.
Not their flesh. What a pity.
What is this? Butter pecan? I don't even remember.
Okay. This is butter pecan from Trader Joe's. From Whole Foods. From Whole Foods. From the cushy suburbanite lifestyle.
I thought everything was supposed to be international.
No, souffle.
No, you should have
these
been like...
These are from New York, by the way.
This is from the faraway place called America.
From America!
Oh my god!
From the New World.
How innovative, how progressive.
I didn't know they could make baked goods. Do they get sugar this time of year?
How long is this video?
5 minutes running?
You're gonna have to put it in a Google Drive.
Yeah, it's alright. Okay. What is next?
The brownies.
The brownies?
From Constantinople.
Oh, these are?
No, that's a souffle. These are the brownies.
Darling.
Oh, we forgot. The
brownies. They are brown. Is that why they call them brownies? Because of the brown color.
Why is Fatiha acting like you Chicago admissions DEI committee is watching us right now?
The accent?
She is.
Like, maybe if you guys were like good at the accents.
Oh! I mean, it adds to the comedy. Okay, so these are the brownies.
They were like standing like in the middle of
poor Amina was trying to highlight the brass.
The fake brass.
The prime English brass.
We from Yorkshire. Yorkshire, darling. Shire.
It's
sure. It's Yorkshire.
Are you sure?
It's Yorkshire.
Oh.
You fake.
Oh dear, I've been exposed as a charlatan, I am. So I'm going back to Brooklyn.
Sitting at the kitchen table, just.
Or on
hardcore judging.
She's in her own world. Yes, darling, do you? And where is this? What is this green elixir?
Like, by the way, Amina, both of them, but Sophia more so, judged me so hard for watching Downton Abbey.
Yeah, I still do.
Now I'm off.
Wait, why the judgment? Because of the British vibes and everything, and yet here they are.
Yeah, it's fun to make fun of, but not fun to watch.
It starts as on the Greek confectionery.
Oh, without me?
It is quite divine.
What's the white
baklava.
Stuff?
It's this, but vanilla. So it is, I don't know, I don't know what that is.
Sorry.
Oh, it's like that cotton candy kind of mitai.
Oh,
chocolate flavor. Chocolate.
Oh. Chocolate. Okay. Is this just fudge?
No. Can you give me a little bit?
She just explained it.
You know the cotton candy type of mitai?
Oh, I thought you were talking only about the vanilla.
No, flavor. But yeah, it's that but in chocolate. But it's is that coated in something?
It looks like it's the same thing but it's coated in chocolate.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, never mind then. Oh. Okay, so it is a cotton candy thing, but whatever.
Yeah. is this the thing that Mare keeps sending stuff?
It's on mine.
Yeah, it's that.
Okay.
This is they're like mini molten lava cakes, as far as I remember.
They are soufflés.
Soufflés.
Soufflés. Not from France. From the Turks.
So, from the Mohammedans.
From the Mohammedans.
The Saracens.
Which one?
These ones.
She's pointing.
The Ishmaelites. The Ishmaelites. Of low birth, of course.
Yes, of course. They're all liars.
And
they shall all rot in hell. Yes, and then?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the sugar. Does it come from Haiti?
My father opened a plantation there recently.
How diverse of him.
What?
Diverse.
Yeah, economically, yes. Yes. We have another one in, what is it? Canada.
Oh. Canada. What do you grow in Canada?
Oh, tobacco, yes. We have tobacco. Yes. Mm-hmm.
I do hear it's quite cold there.
They're a bit too progressive for my tastes.
Canadian's actually good at the accent.
Stop breaking
the fourth wall. We're trying, all right?
She said stop breaking the fourth wall. It's just this common London Street Arab accent. She's walked in with.
London Street Arab.
It's from Anne with an E.
I love Anne with an E.
It's so, oh my dude, I'm rewatching it. It's so good. So good.
Never watched it.
Mm-hmm. I think if you don't like Downton Abbey,
did you ever read Anne of Green Gables?
No,
I loved the book.
Anne with an E is the adaptation.
Adaptation.
Sorry.
She misses her syllables like a commoner.
Oh, thought the word was adoption.
Commoner.
Yeah. We are no charlatans.
Yeah, I just know I'm gonna look so bad in this video. The content is great.
Why?
I didn't put on any makeup on my skin today.
You're not wearing makeup?
Wow.
On my skin.
Wow, flawless.
Mashallah.
No, wow. Wait, you're not wearing
anything? On my skin, no.
Where else would you wear makeup?
I wear on my lips and my eyes.
So. You're not wearing foundation or concealer. Mm-hmm. I thought you were. It looks good.
That's
in the natural blush.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Do you feel hyped now and confident?
I do. She is my hype beast.
You are a beast.
Now, we can call them Saracens and Mohammedans behind their back, but not a beast to their face.
Why not?
Muslims.
Oh.
Muslimics, darling.
Sorry.
By who?
Mohammedans.
Heathens. Pagans.
Oh. Heathens. Pagans. Mm. Right.
Cube worshippers.
You are correct.
Yes.
You know that quaint desert religion? I can't keep this accent.
She called it quaint.
No, this is literally that Pakistani mithai.
Mm.
It's good.
I don't want to try it. Because you said it was Pakistani.
Warranted, actually.
I wanted Turk, and I got Peck.
Mm-hmm.
I want to try the soda though.
Bacola.
Bacola.
I went to a school owned by a Turkish guy.
Bakturk?
It was called Bakturk.
What the heck?
Wait, your brothers went to Bakturk?
Yeah.
When?
You know, they switched schools like 5 times.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Bakturk was one of them.
They went to Salama.
Mm-hmm.
Then they went to Beekenhouse.
Mm-hmm.
Then they went to Bakturk.
Mm.
Then they went to various branches of LGS.
Is she naming madrasas?
Is anyone gonna answer? The answer is yes.
Quaint. I'm gonna have to explain all this
they
to my
do.
Mom.
She went upstairs.
She was like, I'm done.
Yeah.
Yes, the place where they teach children how to be mad. Yes.
How to be mad.
Yeah, I think that's the etymology of the word madrasa.
Mad.
Mad, yes.
That's quite funny.
We've made a discovery, haven't we?
Indeed, we must publish this.
I'm sorry, the heathen holy book. Is that what you speak of?
The
heathen holy book.
Oh.
Indeed.
That thing, what is it called? The law of the pseudo-prophet.
Oh God,
no, that's actually the first translation.
Right now?
The first translation of the Quran into Latin was titled "The Law of the Pseudo Prophet." Yeah.
Damn.
This is getting too blasphemous for me.
1241.
1241. Who wrote that? Latin people?
Yeah, it was it was commissioned by Peter the Venerable.
Mm,
he was some big shot in the Catholic Church.
Anyway, nerd moment!
Okay, alright, so we end in this here. I'm gonna drink some chai.
Just ending it on
a note of blasphemy. Slight blasphemy.
Okay, wasn't this whole thing blasphemous?
Yeah.
Okay, let's just say the shahada then.
With their fingers up. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan rasulullah.
We're never gonna be allowed back in this house.
Three Muslim girls out at 1 o'clock at night.
Astaghfirullah.
What are we doing out at 1 a.m.?
Huh?
Drinking. Bubble tea. That's right. And Ru'afza. That's it.
Running.
All right. Running, yeah.
Running.
Playing cops and robbers.
Getting a workout in.
Yeah.
Hitting the robbers. What did I see?
Running after. Who gets to carry the bag? Staying out late because we went to the burbs to have iftar. Cooked by the hands of a loving auntie who is related to one of us, Farha in particular. Yeah, so Muslim girls out late at night because they went to the burbs to have iftar with their auntie and run around town trying to fight over who carries the bag because we that good. Mashallah. Mashallah.
Inshallah, last night was Laylatul Qadr, and if not, then inshallah we catch Laylatul Qadr, because yesterday was the first odd day, so inshallah, if not yesterday, then a lot of potential. And yeah, we came out here, Ramadan 2022, Ramadan 1443, trying to learn my Islamic timeline. Trying to get a sense of Islam time, you know, decolonizing, you know. Anyway, so last night, very likely, was Laylatul Qadr. All of the signs were there. Very peaceful. Sky was very clear. Moderate weather, no wind. Yeah, very, very nice. Like, you could feel the peace. MashaAllah. So I came out here to see if the sun was going to be rayless, you know, as like the other sign. And very thick rain clouds, so can't see nothing. Not sure if that counts. Yeah, gotta figure that out. Should learn more about these signs. The nitty-gritties.
Yeah, anyway. Inshallah, may Allah accept. Regardless, whatever the case, if not today, we still seek it, right? Just in case. Just in case. But very likely, because today is Friday, Yom Jum'ah, and yesterday was an odd night, the night of Jum'ah. So very likely, it was yesterday. Very likely. Anyway. Alright. As-salamu alaykum. I wonder what the heck I'm gonna do with this video. Absolutely with no regard.
No. Oh my God.
For her.
Ramadan. Ramadan jihad.
That's some real Christian shit.
The smiling fish gives me a lot of joy. But this is my Eid Mubarak.
MashaAllah. Subhanallah.
La ilaha illa Allah, la ilaha illa Allah, la ilaha illa Allah, la ilaha illa Allah, Muhammad Rasulullah, Simd Nabi Bu Jahil Gaya,
Fajr. Hajj is translating some Arabic for her mama, mashallah. I am saving some worms for some reason. Huh? Ma with. It rained a lot yesterday, and somehow all of these worms washed up on these steps right here, and they can't get back. They've fallen and they can't get up. Up to the grassy, muddy parts. Look at here, my friend, trying to struggle for his life. I'm gonna get to him. Look at this guy, poor guy, dead. This other guy, poor guy, dead. Dead, dead. That guy is struggling. There are more ones. I'm gonna get to you, dude, don't worry about it. There was another one, you had a friend. Where'd he go? Did a bird get him? Oh no, here he is. It kind of looked like twigs. Look at this guy, He's trying to fight for his life. He's like, where is the grass? Where is the soil? It was moist here just a few hours ago. Okay, so, yeah, I'm gonna save some worms. Worm saving technique. Use the shtick. Because they feel tickly in my hands. So, shtick. Excuse me. I'm gonna help you now. Oh. Sorry, I poke you for no reason. Okay, here we go. Live, beta, live. How are we doing, the other guys? I dropped them off somewhere. They're here. Whatever. Alright, where's your friend? Ah, here he is. Or she, or they, whatever. Alright, let's get you, my dude. Wormy. Oh, there was this other worm. Well, it was fighting for its life, even though I was trying to save it. Like, it was the feistiest worm I've ever met. I didn't know worms could be that feisty. You alive, kiddo? You alive? I see some movement. Ooh, you are so dry. Okay, you need moisture. Too weak to fight back, eh?
It's all right.
Oh, okay. Look at these dead ones. Poor guys. Oh, they're still alive. Okay, let's save them too.
I was called in by Ranger Hodge. We got a feisty one right here. I've seen your kind before. Let's see what you got. Oh!
He gave up.
I tamed him.
He gave up for the camera.
He got camera shy.
It's a giant rat, aka a possum. Kind of looks like a panda. Oh, no, it doesn't. It looks like a giant rat. Where are your babies? You're kind of cute, but I hear you're vicious. I hear they have rabies. Don't run. We come in peace. Giant rat. The seagull laughs at you. Any last words for tax day? Or Ramadan or anything? No. These people dead. They're dead.
I can't think of a single thing.
The bass has killed them.
Be kind.
Be kind?
Be kind.
Be kind. Like give the bar? Okay, future advice?
Future advice?
Yeah. What's your advice to Hodge 2023?
Hodge 2023?
Apply for an MFA, girl.
No, that's not my advice. My advice is don't be afraid. Just do it.
Like Nike! Okay, what's advice for Fireha 2023?
For Fireha 2023? Go, stop traveling so much. That's my advice.
Where are you settling?
You already know where she's settling.
Virginia.
Okay. Daisy Redneck, yes! Okay, advice for Safia 2023,
Do your taxes on time.
Play the system as long as you can. Play that system like it plays you. Play it harder. You're gonna win, you're a winner. That was reactionary advice. Yo, give me advice.
God got you.
Yo, what?
God got you. Always.
Yeah, that's now and forever, but like advice for me, 2023.
That will be applicable to you in 2023. It will have a new meaning in 2023. Don't worry.
Okay, God got me?
Yeah.
All right. Fareha, give me some advice other than do your taxes on time.
Study for your LSAT.
Oh my God, this girl. I got Dean and Dunya right here. Right here. Write your book.
Write your book.
You better be writing.